Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Luntari. Here in Muth, we tried to get on the ferry. They weren't letting everybody on, and then we were on the guest list, but with a mark next to the name, which means they think we already boarded, so someone might have boarded with our names. But in any case, having some trouble here, so we need a little customer support here at the ticket office. Hey, have you been turned away by the sailors too? The gate agent says. As a matter of fact, yes, says Forte. McBain says they're controlling the ferry for a private enterprise. It's the order from the Duke of Pensola. We must cooperate with the people who work for Rish. I'm sorry. I know your fun is completely ruined. As I promised, I give you a boarding ticket back. Forte and his friends receive a boarding ticket. I'm sorry, but be patient. Wait for the next ferry. That's the only thing I can say now. Are we still going to be able to take place in the competition, or is the ferry going to be too late? I'm so sorry. We didn't expect this to happen. McBain says, take it easy and don't worry about it. It's not your fault. We just want the ferry passengers to enjoy a pleasant voyage by sea. The sailors hired by Rish have been flexing their muscles lately, as if they were controlling the ferry service. The soldiers of Pensola are not helping us. What on earth is the Duke thinking? There's a lot of people that have been saying that lately. Well, we can't even wait over there. Luna says, by the way, who used our name without our permission? Like we should know? I have some idea, says McBain. Oh, really? Forte says, it's Uncle Xiao, isn't it? Probably. So what's our plan? Are we heading back to Envorin? Luna says, look, Forte, poor passengers. They've been waiting all this time. Yeah, that's bad. Should we go and check out what's happening? I think we should and will. I don't know why I sounded like an old lady just then. Alright, so this is just the item shoppy. He's not going to tell us anything. Well, not just the weapon shoppy. He's not going to tell us anything. Rabbit says, as soon as the ferry arrives, big fights break out between the sailors and customers at the pier. It's high time the soldiers of Envorin enforce law. People will get injured soon. Yeah, if they haven't already. Travelers come all the way to Muth to get on the ferry, only to find that there's no ferry for them to take. They have no choice but to return. I've read this already. Okay. Sham says, Grandpa, and she's crying. I'm hungry. Poor girl, please be patient. They don't have anything to eat here. Oh, okay. I'll be patient. Weeping silently. Pretty sad. Before we go talk to them... I was gonna go talk to her, but we... We can't get there without passing through the inn anyway, so never mind. I think the inn is the only way to go. Poor girl, says Una. You must be hungry. I'm okay. I don't want to give Grandpa trouble. It's a lot of weeping. Forte says, hey, we have some fresh bread. Should we give it to her? Yes. If you want, have this. Forte gave some fresh bread to Sham. Really? Can I have it? It's so kind of you, Forte, says Una. Well, says McBean. Here, girl, eat up. Sean is biting into the bread. Wow, this bread is so fluffy. Thank you. That's the bread from the, bread... I was going to say factory, but it's bread store... Bread bakery. Back in... Again, is that Envorin or Dogarna? I forget. Let's just talk to this girl really quick. So she's not forgotten. I'm bored. She's not saying anything new anyway. What about this guy? Yeah, he said that before. Okay. He said that too. Who are those sailors anyway? They're absolutely unbelievable. How can this nonsense go unpunished? I feel hungry too. So they don't let people on the ferry and they take the food. What's going on with this country? They have monsters near Dogarna and the sailors are bossing the people around in Muth. Things keep irritating me. I got so angry I suddenly feel hungry. Well, that's a problem. If things don't improve, not only... Yeah, she's said that. Okay. We're both having a hard time, aren't we? I wanted to grab a bite to eat since the next ferry won't be here for some time. But those vulgar sailors took all the food they had around here. What kind of people are they? Says McBean. It's unforgivable. Forte says they're signaling the departure. The ferry is left. I heard a rumor about a guy called Captain Thomas. He is a pirate, but a good one who chooses to fight evil. Yeah, you can see me read the books of those in Tear of a Million. Or, well, I have separate videos up of the book readings also. If the Pensola soldiers can't do anything, we should call Captain Thomas to teach these guys a lesson or two. Even if the next ferry arrives, those sailors may again flex their muscle to keep us from boarding. What will happen then? I hope someone will do something. The bread you gave me was so fluffy and delicious. Thank you. Alright. Something else has gotta happen. We're gonna leave and see... Oh, here we go. Bartender says, Mister, can I have a word with you? Forte says, yes. Are you going to Envorin? I have a favor to ask of you. I don't want to go back to Envorin. What is it? Says Una. You've seen. Everyone here is hungry. It just breaks my heart watching these people. There's a bakery in Envorin. Could you ask them to deliver some bread for them? Oh, that's right. The bakery is in Envorin, not Dogarna. McBain says, oh, that can be arranged easily. What? Do you know Edgar's bakery? Our friend is helping the store, says Forte. Una says, we should quickly inform Altos and hurry things up. That's right, says McBean. Don't worry, we'll take care of it. Thank you. I owe you one. I guess we're running all the way back to Envorin. Please say hello to the baker. Tell him hungry passengers will be waiting. Alright. Just checking to see if there's any new dialogue here. Alright, let's... I guess we're going back to Envorin then. Hopefully when we come back here, we'll just be, like, teleported back. With the magic of story progression. I love how they give us so much room to pass. So polite. Try not to run into them accidentally. Almost ran into that one. Just about there. Here we are. Alright, so... just have to take a small drink, and I think... I don't know. These people say new things, or we're just gonna go right to the bakery. We'll go right to the bakery. These two said the same two things anyway. Actually, maybe we'll go bother the castle guard again. Yeah, he didn't say anything new either. Alright. To the bakery! It's probably down here then. There it is. Edger says, you're back. Altos says, hello again. How is Muth? Well, says Forte. Forte told Altos the situation at the port of Muth. That's terrible. Una says, so the passengers at the terminal were angry and hungry and... I get upset just talking about it. That's not that bad. Altos says, anyway, we better deliver bread to them quickly. Maybe some things to put on the bread? Some cheese? Some ham or something? Alright, says Edger. Let's bring them a lot of delicious bread. Yes. The head guard says, is the owner here? Welcome, says Edger. How may I help you, sir? I heard that you employ a musical group called the McBain Company. People say that they performed in Envorin and received rave reviews. Do you know where they are now? Where? There. The McBain Company is right beside you, sir. What? You look awfully familiar. Do we? Says McBain. Anyway, the Duke of Pensola would like your performance at the castle. Oh, really? People, prepare and come to the castle at once. Oh, jeez. That was unexpected. Forte says, come to the castle, huh? McBain says, as I had expected. We got their attention. Well, he expected it. Edgar says, the Duke is looking for performers who could win at the audition? At the audition. Not a question. If the performers he nominates win, his reputation among the people of eminence will go up. McBain says he must really like to put on airs. Forte says, but we are already nominated by Ambassador Guerrero. It doesn't matter, you see, says McBain. We've got the opportunity to see the Duke. We can convey to him the message from the Viscount. But what about the bread, says Una. Don't worry about it, says Altos. When ready, I'll deliver the bread to Muth myself. Yeah, says Edger. We'll take care of the bread ourselves. All right, let's bake a plenty. Well, we got plenty of stuff on the shelves there. Yes, says Altos. Altos says yes a lot. McBain says, okay, we'll head for the castle. Aw, says Forte. Ruff! The rat says, Q? Bless you, I guess. They're so pumped up, says Una. It's not a raid, you know. The Duke is not a foolish man. He is only deceived by Rish's sweet words. Please wake him up with your performance. Alright, I'll bake a lot of bread. A lot of bread. Let me just check with these two to see if they say anything new. Nope. Okay. Yeah, they really like Xiao's performance, but Xiao is missing in action. Hi, I heard that you can now see the Duke. Good for you. Please enter. It's a big building, says Forte. Una says, I may get lost. How about you, Jan? Roof! Whoa! A nasty sailor says, hey, you, don't just stand there. A vulgar sailor says, hey, don't cause trouble in the Duke's castle, alright? It's not much coming from a vulgar sailor, sorry. A nasty sailor says, okay. Hey, move away, dog. Jeez. Those sailors we saw earlier, says Forte. Una says, I remember them coming out of the ferry. McBain says, they dress like sailors. Probably they're ex-pirate underlings controlled by Rish. Ex-pirate underlings. It's so boring. I wish I could go and guard the party. They must be eating plenty of delicious food. He's not disciplined enough, says McBain. I envy those who were sent to the island. Envy, envy. No book. No book! McBain says, Forte, where are you going? We must talk to the Duke this time around. Now we're gonna talk to this guy again. Guessing the Duke is behind there? I don't know. The Duke will soon leave for the party on Riatam Island. After he leaves, we must defend the castle ourselves. I'm getting nervous. Why, does the Duke actually help defend the castle? I don't think that he would do that. We must protect the castle in the absence of the Duke to answer his trust in us. Okay. Sarah says, the Duke seems very busy lately. He is attending the party on Riatam Island in an official capacity. He's working too hard. Some people criticize the Duke, but I know he is a sincere, industrious person. I respect the Duke. Not everyone does. Alright, nothing in here. That looked like a fake door, I don't know. Is that where the Duke is? Is he in there? Yeah, that's him. Alright, we'll go there last. Let's look around. Milka says, sighs. When Viscount Igor was here, the castle was filled with energy. Ever since he left, the place has become really cold. Rish has a bad taste. How can he send such rude sailors as his messengers? Oh no, he's just like them, I guess. Was it the butler? Or the attendant? Please forgive the discourtesy of the Duke. He thinks he is doing his best for the good of the Principality of Pensola. I hope your performance will thaw the frozen mind of the Duke. Well, there's only one way to find out, is there? I got tired waiting. Make sure you don't do anything stupid. What is it? We just passed the sailors, Miss Forte. Oh, those messages from Rish. They were meeting with the Duke just now. What's wrong? Go and see the Duke quickly. Duke says, oh, I was waiting for you. You're the McBain Company. I have heard of your excellent performance in town. Hmm? You're those fellows from the other day. So what, says McBain. You told me to come, so we came. Well, that's fine. I made you come here to hear your performance personally. What do you think? It's a rare opportunity for you. You want us to perform in front of you? Asked McBain. We're afraid it's not possible. What? We earn a scanty living day in, day out from the gratuities of customers. We're honored to be desired by you, but our performance is mass entertainment after all. Mass entertainment. We won't be able to please your highness's noble ears. I don't care. Just perform. You must be joking. The leader of the company is a daughter like myself. Forte says, and the performers are kids like ourselves. We also have a dog, says Una. Ruff! Shut up and start your performance. If you insist, says McBain, I'll perform one tune for you. Playful Birds. I forgot that one. Thought it might have been a new one. The dog was like walking extra fast. I don't know if you guys saw that. Amazing! You're really good! It was a magnificent performance. Well, you could only gauge the technique of one member. Yours is as good as those performances I've heard at the International Theater in Cavaro. McBain says, thank you for your praise. It is our extreme pleasure. Well then, the McBain Company shall head off. Wait. I said wait. I have something to tell you. Are we trying to give him the Viscount's letter? If you want to give us a performance fee, please send it to Edgar's Bakery. That's not what I want to say. I apologize to you for my discourtesy the other day. So please, will you listen to me? Alright, we can at least listen to you. You know about the party in Riatam Island, don't you? On the last day, the party moves onto a boat. We heard about the audition to select the nomination that will play at the party on the boat, said McBain. Since you know, I'll cut to the chase and go right into the main subject. Are you interested in entering the audition? I will nominate you myself. I'm sorry, but we're not interested. But why? Forte says we already earned a nomination from Ambassador Garena of Buridan. You were too late, says Una. Then why don't you annul the promise with the Ambassador Buridan? If you accept my nomination, I'll match the winning prize if you win. Don't worry about the poor aristocrat from Buridan. It would be a smart move to cooperate with the Principality of Pensola instead. Ha ha ha! Ha ha ha! Jan fell asleep. What's wrong? McBain says, we heard you loud and clear. You don't mind trampling down the feelings of others and breaking the rules for your own gain, do you? What? Forte says, do you know what's happening at the port of Muth, Duke? Risha's henchmen are wrongfully occupying the ferry and allowing only the party guests to board the ship. General passengers are denied boarding and are in great distress. Una says the bakeries had all their flour taken to Riatam Island. They can't bake bread without flour, and the bakery in Envorin had to close for a while. McBain says in Dogarna they couldn't exterminate the monster because you had sent the guardsmen at the checkpoint to Riatam Island. Your childhood friend was grieving. Igul. So he sent you here to complain about it. Complain? That's not what we're here for. We just wanted to know why so many people we met in Pensola looked unhappy and concerned, just like the Viscount. We've been wondering why, but now we know. Huh. You don't know a thing about governing a country. Don't give me a smart mouth. You're right that I am giving favors to Rish. However, what I do is for the future of this country. Look at Envorin. It was a poor, rural town just a few years ago, but now we have wide roads lined with beautiful houses and shops. The livelihood of people is assured only when their country is prosperous. You and Igul have no business criticizing me. McBain says, those who live with the evil die with the evil. It's pitiful how people lose sight of right and wrong. Your makeshift happiness will disappear in a second if Rish snaps his fingers. Don't you understand that? You... Forte says, you'll soon find out that things are not how you wanted them to be. McBain says, in the end, there will be only a miserable duke left without his country. He himself may not live to see his miserable end. How could the duke not live to see his own end? How dare you? Someone. Uh-oh. Yes, Your Highness? They insulted me. Arrest them. Yes, Your Highness. Jan's not having it. Ruff! No! They're standing there with armor on and they have spears. And they're scared of a dog with a barrel tied around its neck with a desert rat with a ribbon on top of it. Captain, don't be such a coward. Yes, sir. He's being a coward. Captain, we can't defeat them. You're all pathetic, says the head guard. Hey, leave here at once. I mean leave. I thought you were arresting us. Hey! Ha! Says McBain. Was he gonna punch? He punched him. Yeah, watch out for that McBain punch. They are strong. Duke, says McBain. Kuh. You don't know. You don't know that the Viscount tried to take down the monster by himself to protect his people and got badly wounded. What? Igul was badly wounded? Forte says he went alone to exterminate the monster you let run amok. Is Igul all right? His wound is healing, says McBain. You don't have to worry about his health. It's Viscount Igul who is worried about you. Forte says, Duke, please take a look. Viscount Igul asked us to give these to you. Forte handed the velvet bag to the Duke. Oh yeah, with the childhood marbles. Oh, these are the marbles from that day. McBain says, you had refused to receive the letter, so we went back to Dogarna to return it to the Viscount. Oh, that's right, we did return that. He then entrusted these with us and told us to give them to you if we had a chance. I don't know what they mean to you, but he told us this. If you don't wake up after looking at them, the Principality of Pensola is doomed. This is a keepsake from our childhood. Forte, you said your name was. When we were your age, I couldn't beat Igul in academic achievements or swordsmanship. And I had a bit of inferiority complex toward him. But I was always better than Igul with marbles. I used to take dozens of marbles from him. I got overconfident and threw a marble contest in the castle, inviting the children of Envorin. In a semi-final, however, I suffered a total defeat against the baker's son. The baker? Says Una. I was vexed and ashamed. I felt that the only pride I had was shattered. I called my guardsmen and had the baker's son thrown out of the venue. I then shamefully proceeded to the final. But that's against the rules, says Forte. Duke says, come to think of it, that was the first time I broke the rules. The contest went on, and somehow the marble, clumsy Eagle survived to reach the final. Eagle didn't say a word, but he was furious. He didn't look at me or talk to me. He just continued to shoot marbles silently. The usually good-natured Eagle being seriously angry, I was scared. I kept trembling, and in the end, I lost. When he took away the marbles from me, Eagle spoke to me. You're the future ruler of Pensola. What are you doing breaking the rules yourself instead of setting a good example? I felt so shameful I went to the bakery to apologize. Then Eagle finally smiled. So, says Forte, those are the marbles he took from you. The Duke says, I was doing the same thing without knowing. For the country, for the people. I was making grand statements, but I was in fact trampling down the feelings of others and breaking the rules again. I can't blame Eagle for running out of patience with me. It's not too late, says Forte. As a child, you realized the mistakes you made, right? That's right, says Una. You can do the same thing now, Duke. I'm so ashamed of myself. All right. I'll break off all my ties with Rish. Captain. Yes, Your Highness. Cancel my attendance to the party. Order all soldiers to return from Riatom Island and go back to their original posts. Also, arrest Rish's men to make sure the ferry service to and from the port of Muth goes back to normal. Be careful not to cause any inconvenience to the passengers. Send my orders immediately. Yes, Your Highness. He's got Jan cornered him. Come, says the head guard. He's talking to him like he's a dog. Yes, sir, but... Jan, says Forte. It's okay now. Ruff. McBain says, you made the right decision. I hope someday I'll look back and feel good about having made it. It won't be long, says McBain. I was lost. I thank you and Eagle for waking me up. The Duke of Pensola was touched by the sincerity of the Viscount through Forte and company and realized his mistakes. I thought it was a typo. I was supposed to be the... though. If you have time, please stay here as long as you want. McBain says, we made a promise with Ambassador Gareno. We should be heading to Riatom Island. I see. Then I can't keep you. Oh, I almost forgot the performance fee I promised. Did he promise that? I guess. Forte and his friends receive 1,000 gents. It's a lot, says Forte. Thank you, Duke. I was thinking to give you 10 times as much. Well, you can do that. However, breaking off with Rish will surely make the financial situation of Pensola much tighter. If I'm not careful and keep spending, I'll be scolded by you again. McBain says, it's our loss, but that's an admirable attitude. By the way, says Forte, do you know anything about resonance stones, Duke? Resonance stones? No, I've never heard of them. Una says, they are small stones on which the musical scores of composer Leon are engraved. We don't have anything like that in my family, but of course I know the name Leon. I see. How about you? The attendant says, I don't know them either. All right, says Forte. Oh, I just remembered, says the Duke. Talking about Leon, it's not a stone, but we have a musical score composed by Leon. Here it is. I have an idea. Why don't you take this with you? May we? Says McBain. If we keep it here, it's a waste of treasure. The value of this score is revealed only when it is played by those who love music. I know that now. Forte says, wow, we have Leon's musical score. Forte and his friends obtained the musical score of Forest and Sea Memory. Cool. McBain says, Forest and Sea Memory? I've never heard of the title. Oh my, the mellow yet witty beginning is superb. It's a masterpiece. The Duke says, they say it was left on Riatam Island. Forte says, Riatam Island, where the party will be held? The island became Rish's property 3 years ago. Before that, they had a small village on the island. McBain says, that means we may be able to find something Leon left on Riatam Island. Forte says, now I'm looking forward to our visit to Riatam Island. Yes, let's go, says McBain. Well, the McBain Company shall bid your highness farewell now. They don't change, says Una. As soon as they all hear Leon, they get anxious all of a sudden. I will give strict punishment to the outlaw sailors working for Rish. Please rest assured and leave for the port of Muth. If I remember correctly, Leon visited Envorin around 50 years ago, but I don't think he came to the castle. Your brilliant performance will surely become a legend of Castle Envorin. Okay. Well, we finally got in here, and our business is done. Your performance moves those who listen. You taught me the true beauty of music. Your performance brightened up the air in the castle. The Viscount is coming back to the castle, too. I'm sure liveliness will return to the castle. All thanks to your performance. This is empty, right? Yeah. The Duke canceled his trip to Riatam Island. I lost my chance to take care of the castle in his absence. Well, you're so worried about it. To tell you the truth, I was a little worried. The others are all coming back, and I'm relieved. Oh, the other soldiers. I thought you wanted the Duke to help you defend the castle. I heard you perform from here. It was truly magnificent. The Duke is so beaming, as if the clouds in his mind have all been lifted. You haven't seen him. I learned that truly great music calms one's mind. Okay. Bye, castle people. Oh, this guy? Did I talk to them? He soldiers yawning. It's boring. McBain says, shall I teach you a Zen lesson? No, no, thank you, sir. I don't need a Zen lesson, sir. You sure? You don't sound sure about that, I don't know. In addition to giving a great musical performance, they tell me you also pulled off a brilliant fight. In the end, you captured the heart of the Duke. You guys are really special. Yeah, I didn't think it was that gonna be that easy. I was told to welcome the McBain Company. You can enter any time. Please come in. We're just walking out, though.